Dear students, welcome to the science class. So in the last class we completed our third topic, that is nothing but fabrics to the fiber. In today's class we are going to start with new brand topic, that is nothing but acids, bases and solids. So dear students, so first we are going to discuss about the acid and bases. After that we are going to discuss about the salts. And in this chapter we are going to discuss how we are going to identify that a solution is acidic and a solution is a basic by using different type of indicators. So before going to that thing, first we are going to discuss about the acid and bases, and before that we are going to do an activity. We are going to do an activity. In that activity, what we are going to do here, we are going to take some substances and we are going to test those substances. So we are going to take some substances. Those substances we are going to test. So we already have three type of test. One is sour test. Second one is bitter test. And third one is salty one. Salty one. So any other in previous week or in previous salty. So here we can take any other test. So why we are going to test those things? Because we are going to identify what is acid and what is base by using this activity. So let us take the first example which is given here, which is lemon juice. First example is lemon juice. How that lemon juice tests? Is it going to test sour or it is going to test bitter? It is going to test as sour. Since lemon juice is a sour test, having a sour test. In the same manner, if you take second example which is given in your textbook, is nothing but what? Orange juice. If you take the orange juice here, how it is test? It is going to test sweet, or it is going to test salty, or it is going to test bitter, or it is going to test sour. Orange juice is also having a sour test. But in the same manner, if you take third example, that is nothing but vinegar. Vinegar, which is used in the kitchen purpose of making of pickles or making chicken 65, in that we are going to add the vinegar. So how does the vinegar test? It is also sour test. It is also having the sour test. In same way, if we take the fourth example, that is nothing but curd. We already know that milk is going to test sweeter, but in case of curd, it is going to test sour. So the test of the milk is also what? It is sour test only. Right, it is also sour test. So lemon juice, orange juice, vinegar and curd are also sour test. The same manner, if you take the fifth example, that is nothing but tamarind. Tamarind, that is nothing but emily. So how does the emily test? It is also sour. Sour or sour test. Right. So if you take the sixth example here, sugar, how it will test? Sugar is salty or sweet, or sour or bitter? It is sweet. So the taste of the sugar is sweet. In the same way, if you take the example of the common salt, how it tastes? Common salt has the salty taste. So the taste of the common salt is salty. In the same way, if you take another example here, if you take the baking soda, how it tastes? Baking soda tastes as bitter. Not that much bitter, it may be small amount of bitter. So in that baking soda we are going to add the lemon juice. It is sour in taste. Because of that thing we are going to test baking soda as sour. But if you take directly the baking soda and if we test it, the baking soda is going to give you what test? It is going to give the bitter test. In the same way, if you take the example of the grapes, how they test? Grapes are also sour in taste. In the same manner, if you take the unripe mango, unripe mango which we are going to use for eating purpose, which spice, that is nothing but chili powder and the salt. So we are going to take the chili powder and salt and mix those things, and we are going to take the piece of the mango and we are going to eat that mango. So how does that mango taste there? It is also going to taste as so. Right, in the same manner, if you take another thing, that is nothing but if you take the cucumber. Cucumber, it tastes as the bitter. It has the bitter taste. Right, if you take the another example, that is nothing but calcium hydroxide, that is nothing but lime water. Lime water, or if you take it, lime solution or limestone. Limestone in water. So don't eat it, don't taste it. If oil having a pan masala or having a pan, in that we are going to put the limestone which is dissolved in the water, and we are going to put that thing on the that pan as a chunna. Right, soon. So how it tastes? It tastes bitter. Bitter. So while doing this activity, you should take the help of the teacher. When teacher say taste it, then we have to taste it. Unless like you do not have to taste those things. Since some of them have harmful effects also. Not here, but some of the other things, they are the harmful effects. So if you see here, all those things, see here. If you see the lemon juice, orange juice, vinegar, curd, all those things, they have the sour taste. And some things have the sweet as well as salty taste, and some other things have the bitter taste. So if you check here, all those having the sour taste, the sour taste of those substances is because of the some material or some chemical which is present in those substances. So that sour taste is because of nothing but it is because of the acids. It is because of the acids. So we can say that acids are nothing but, by this example we can say that the sour taste of all the substances because of the acids, we can say that acids are those which taste sour in taste. The taste of those things is sour. Right, so acids are those which have sour taste. That means lemon juice contains acid, orange juice contains acid, vinegar also contains acid, curd is also contains acid, tamarind is also contains acid, sugar doesn't contain acid since it is a sweet one, common salt is contains salty one because of that it doesn't contain any acid, baking soda it is bitter so it doesn't contain any acids, but grape sour in taste because of that they contain acid, the unripe mango it is also sour in taste because of that it also contains acids, cucumber bitter in taste, and limestone it is also bitter in taste, it doesn't contain. So here what we have to say here, acids are nothing but those are the things which are sour in taste, the taste of those things is sour. Right, so why does the acid name came? Acid came from a Greek word. Acid came from a Greek word known as acere. Known as acere. So acere means sour taste. Acere means what? Sour taste. So acids are nothing but the taste of those things is sour one. So those are nothing but what? Acids. Those are nothing but what? Those are the acids. So acids are the sour the taste. For example, for the acids. Examples for the acid containing substances are lemon juice, orange juice, vinegar, curd, tamarind, etc. So then, what are the bases? If you check here, the baking soda has a bitter taste, cucumber has a bitter taste, limestone has a bitter taste. If you take the example of the baking soda as well as the limestone, if you take those things in your hand and put some water into those things, what will happen? It is going to give a slippery form, or it is going to give a soapy form, and there is the formation of the bubbles in our hand. So bases are those things which is going to give a soapy form, which is going to give a soapy medium. right? So each medium, as well as they taste bitter. So we can say that bases are those which have bitter taste and have a soapy form. So they are going to give a soapy form. That means they are going to form a bubble when we add those things into a water and if you rub it. So they are going to form a soapy form. So whichever these substances which have a bitter taste as well as soapy form, those are nothing but what? Those are the bases. So these are the acids which have sour taste, the bases which have the bitter taste. Alright. So if you see here, is it possible that we are going to identify acids as well as bases by testing only? Is it possible? Now you know that hydrochloric acid is there. If you check the batteries, in those batteries there is the presence of the sulfuric acid. So how we are going to identify that sulfuric acid? By testing that acid which is present in the battery. Is it possible? If you test those things, your tank is going to burn out. Your face is going to burn out. So is it not possible to test every and everything, every item, every substance by testing it? Identification is not possible. For that reason, for identifying the acids, for the determination of the acids as well as bases, we have some other substances. Those substances are nothing but what? Those are the indicators. By using the indicators, we are going to identify the acids as well as we are going to identify the base. Not only by the test, by the indicators also we are going to check the acids as well as bases. Since it is not possible to check everything by testing it. So if you check the, is it not possible to test every, if you take the neem, leave up the neem which is bitter in taste, it is not possible since it is very very bitter. In the same manner, if you take the hydrochloric acid or sulfuric acid which is used for the batteries, if you test it, your tongue is going to burn out and your face is going to burn out. So it is damaging one. Because of that thing, it is not possible to test everything and say it is acid or base. For that reason we have a indicators. So let us discuss about the indicators. So what are the indicators? Indicators are nothing but these are the special type of substances which are used for the determination of acid or base, acidic nature or basic nature of the substances. We already know that it is not possible to test everything and say that it is acid or it is a base or it is a salt. But by using a special type of substances, we can identify that these substances are acidic and these substances are basic. So those special type of substances are nothing but what? It is the indicators. So indicators are the special type of substances. Which are used for the test of acidic and basic nature. So we are using the special type of substances. We are going to identify acidic as well as a basic substances. So there are two types of indicators. One is natural indicator. Second one is synthetic indicator. So what do you mean by natural indicator and what do you mean by synthetic indicator? So before that, I am going to tell about what is indicator. So while traveling on the bike, If you want to turn on the right side, you are going to switch on the button or switch on the indicator of the right side so that you are going to go in the right hand direction. In the same manner, if you want to move into the left hand direction, you are going to start the left side indicator so that it is going to detect that the behind person or the persons which are coming in the forward direction, you are going to indicate them that you are going to go in the left hand direction. In the same manner, by the light, how we are identifying that the person is going to the right or the person is going to the left, in the same manner, by using the indicators, by using some color changes, we are going to identify that a solution is a acidic or a solution is a basic. So it is in the same manner as the indicators which are used in the bikes. But here we are going in the liquid form, there we are using in the form of the light. So in the indicators, there are two types. One is the natural indicator, another one is the synthetic or artificial indicator. So what is the natural indicator? If you remember, in the fibers also, there are two types. One is the natural fiber, another one is the synthetic fiber. So what is the natural fiber? Natural fiber is nothing but which is occurring naturally. Which is occurring naturally, which is already present in the nature. In the same manner, synthetic fiber is what? Synthetic fiber is man-made. It is made by the chemicals, it is made by the man. So in the same manner, the natural indicators are nothing but which are present naturally. Which are present naturally. There is no other process is going to do of making of those indicators. Those are already present in the nature. In the same manner, if you take these synthetic indicators are made from the chemicals by the human being or man. So they are man-made, whereas natural indicators are already present in the nature. So these are already present in the nature. They are already present in the nature. Present in the nature, so these are the man-made. Synthetic indicators are the man-made, or you can call it as chemicals. Or these are nothing but another name for these things are artificial. These are also known as artificial indicators. So example for the natural indicators are, if you take one take, you can take the litmus paper. So about this natural indicators as well as synthetic indicators, we are going to study in the detail in this class only. So just I am going to give the examples. So litmus paper is a natural indicator. If you take the example of the turmeric, which is also a natural indicator. Turmeric is also a natural indicator. And the litmus China rose petals. So another name for it is gudar. So China rose is also a natural indicator. By using China rose, we are also going to identify the acid as well as base. So if you take the example of the ETC. If you take the example of the synthetic indicator, those are nothing but phenolphthalein indicator, as well as methyl orange. We have two types of indicators in the synthetic. One is the phenolphthalein indicator and methyl orange indicator. So these are the solution. When we add the solution, there is the color change is going to happen in those acid or color basic solution. By that color change, we are going to identify the acid or base solution using these indicators. So these are the natural occurring indicators, litmus paper, turmeric, China rose, and these are the synthetic indicators. Here we can use the red cabbage also. So red cabbage is also an example for the natural indicator. So these are about the indicators. In detail about these indicators, we are going to study in the next class. Up to that point, we are going to study different substances containing different acids. So if we already know that tamarind contains what? It contains acid, since it is a sour test. In the same manner, if you take the examples of the vinegar, it also contains acid. Because of that, it has the sour test. So which acid it contains, we have to discuss now. So take the substance here on side and the name of the acid and found it. Take the name of the acid on side. And in which fluid or in which thing it is going to form, we have to take this in another side. So if you take first example is the acetic acid.
acetic acid. It is present in the vinegar. So 5 to 8% of acetic acid in water is nothing but what? It is the vinegar. So acetic acid is present in the vinegar. If you take the second example of the acid which is given in the is nothing but formic acid. It is nothing but what? Formic acid. There is another name of formic acid is there, that is nothing but retinoic acid. Another name for the formic acid is there, that is nothing but retinoic acid. In the same manner, it has another name, that is nothing but ethinoic acid. It has another name, that is nothing but ethinoic acid. So formic acid is present in the ant sting. Ant sting. So whatever sting which you are going to, if you take the bite of a sting of any microalgae or any insect, that insect in that sting they contain what? They contain the formic acid or methanoic acid. Because of that acid, we are going to suffer burning sensation. We are going to suffer what? We are going to suffer burning sensation. So next, citric acid. Next acid is citric acid. So this citric acid is present in the citrus fruits. Like lemon juice, it is a citrus fruit. Like orange, it is also a citrus fruit. Right? So in the citrus fruit, we have the citric acid. So for example, lemon contains citric acid, orange contains citric acid, and etc. So other examples can be given. So whatever the citrus fruit is nothing but which contains the citric acid, for example, lemons, orange, etc. If you take the next acid, that is nothing but oxalic acid. Oxalic acid. So in which case the oxalic acid will be present? In the tomato, amla, or in the spinach. Oxalic acid present in the spinach. Or else it is also present in the tomato. Oxalic acid is also present in the tomato. Right. In the same manner, if you take the ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid. So it is the another name of the vitamin C. It is the scientific name of the vitamin C. Ascorbic acid. So where does the ascorbic acid is present? Ascorbic acid is present in the amla in the citrus fruit. It is present in the amla and in the citrus fruit. Right. In the same way, if you take the tartaric acid. Sixth acid is what? Tartaric acid. It is present in the tamarind. That is nothing but imbli. It is present in the tamarind or imbli. Or grapes. Tamarind, grapes, unripe mangoes. Unripe mangoes. Because of that, because of this acid, they taste as sour taste. The test as so. In the same manner, we are going to see some substances which contain base. So here I am going to take the name of the base. Name of the base and found it. In which case it is going to be formed. So if you take the example here, calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide. It is nothing but it is a base, it has the bitter taste, that is nothing but water, lime water. We can say it as lime water. So it is found in the lime water. So whatever the lime water we are going to use, that is nothing but what? It is the calcium hydroxide. In the same way, if you take ammonium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide. So it is found in, ammonium hydroxide is found in the window cleaner. So whatever the window cleaner we are going to use in the vehicle or in the house, it contains the ammonium hydroxide. Because of that ammonium hydroxide, it is going to give the soapy solution. If it is going to give the soapy solution, what does it mean? It is going to clear all those dust particles which are present on those things. So ammonium hydroxide can be used for the purpose of that thing. Next, sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide. पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड और पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. सो वेयर डज दे प्रेजेंट? सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड एंड पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस सोप. दे आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस सोप बिकॉज ऑफ दैट थिंग और soap is going to give the bubbles of the solution. Those bubbles are going to use for the purpose of the cleaning of the cloth. So in this manner, these are used. At last, magnesium hydroxide. So where does the magnesium hydroxide is used? As the milk of magnesium. So where does it is used? It is used in digestion. Why? When indigested food is present, when acidity happens, at that time we are going to use the magnesium hydroxide. That is nothing but milk of magnesium for the purpose of clearing the acidity. So this is about the some acids as well as bases where we found it, and as well as the indicator. So in the detail of those indicators we are going to study in the next class, as well as we are going to study how those indicators are used for the identification of the acid as well as base in the next class. Up to that point, thank you, take care, stay well, stay well.